Good morning, KB kids, and welcome to worship today. I am KB, and I am so excited that you joined us for worship. Is this your first time? Well, if so, you are in for a real treat. If you're a returner, welcome back. Here at KB Kids, we play games, we sing songs, we do scripture memory, and of course, we open the Word and hear what God has to say to us. Are you ready? I hope so, because it's this way to KB.
I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder, KB, 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 say. I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder, KB, 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 say. I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. Here we go. We're reading God's word. We're doing what we heard. We're spreading God's love from John chapter 3. We're memorizing scripture. We don't hide it.
Well, howdy there, KB kids, and welcome to worship today. I am Miss D, and guess what? It is volume number 59. Yes, it is volume number 59. We are on part 4 of our Wild, Wild West series, and I am so excited to be worshiping with you guys this morning. So, how was your week? I hope you had a great week. I had a great week. I had a busy week. I was outside. I'm coaching softball, and I've been having a lot of fun and just been super busy doing all my things. But I love each and every Sunday that we stop and we take the time and we worship together. So I'm excited to worship with you guys. We have such a fun and exciting lineup for you today. So I hope you guys are ready. But you know what we got to do. Before we do anything else, we got to say our confessions. Why, Miss D? Well, I'll tell you, folks. We say our confessions because the Bible says we can have what we say. So when we say good things about ourselves, then that means they can come to pass. So I don't know about you, but I need good things to happen in my life. So I want to confess what God says about me over myself as much as I can. So, if you guys are ready, we're going to have one of our KB friends who came here in the studio and lead us in confessions. Are you guys ready? I hope so. Here we go.
I love God. I'm all the KB friends. I bless the Holy Spirit and the Holy Spirit. I love my God. I love my God. And I pray for my God. But I love anything else. And all this for Jesus name, amen. I am a whole among God, that is damned in God's deeds. The hope of blessing is you that be, the best of truth, the best way to righteousness, the truth of faith, and the source of the Spirit, the word of God. And then use my armor to knock down, to cross, and to stop anything but another God. And this is my amen. I'm a winner, but the beats and leader, to set the captive free. The need man, the path of righteousness, and need this name. Why? Because I don't want to see.
Who's a righteous seed?
I'm
awake
to see.
All right, say bye for now.
Bye for now.
Oh, thank you so much, Gabe. I so appreciate you guys helping us out with confessions. Guys, it's not too late. If you want to get in and helping us on confessions, you can send in your videos. No matter how young you are, no matter how old you are, go ahead and send us a video of you saying confessions, and you can lead us one Sunday. All right, so like I said, we are on our fourth week of our Wild, Wild West of Faith series. And we have been talking about obedience. We have been talking about consequences. We have been talking about a lot of things. And today we're talking about the God who does the impossible thing. There is nothing impossible with God. So that's what we're talking about today. And you know what? Back in the Old West, they used to have this thing called high noon. High noon is pretty much just 12 o'clock noon, but high noon is the time when the sun is the highest in the sky. And so they would call it high noon because a lot of things would take place. People would say, you know what, I'll meet you at high noon, or you know what, we'll deal with this later, you know, high noon. So high noon was a really important part of the Wild Wild West movies and genre and things like that. So we're going to talk about today a special thing that happened in the Bible, a miracle that happened in the Bible, where God caused the sun to stand still for like a whole day, right? Crazy, I know. All right, before we get into that, it is time for praise and worship. It is time to lift Jesus higher. And because today we are talking about the impossible God, today we're starting off with nothing is impossible. So let's sing it together. Nothing is impossible.
Through you, I can do anything. I can do all things, 'cause it's you who gives me strength. Nothing is impossible. Through you, blind eyes are open, strongholds are broken. I am living by faith.
Shout it out.
Come on, let's dance.
I love the words of that song. I love the beat. I love the rhythm. It's such a great song. Well, we're not going to stop. We're going to continue on, and we're going to go into super wonderful. There is nobody like our God. Do you guys know that? I hope so. I hope if you've been watching KB Kids for the last 58 weeks, here is 59 weeks, I hope that you know that there is nothing, there's no one like our God. So let's sing it together. Super wonderful God.
My God is strong. He'll do anything big or small. Nothing is impossible.
you enjoyed worshiping with us today, and we are going to get right into our scripture memory. We're going to get right into our scripture memory time, and our scripture today comes from Ephesians 3, verse 20. And today I'm going to read the Message version because I love what it says. Here's what it says. It says, God can do anything for more than you could ever imagine or guess or request in your wildest dreams. Let's read it again. God can do anything far more than you could ever imagine or guess or request in your wildest dreams. So do you guys believe that? Do you guys believe that there is nobody like our God? Your wildest dreams, the things that you're thinking, oh, that would be so cool if that happened to me, or that would be so cool if I ever could do that. The Bible says that God can do far more than that. He is the God of the impossible. So let's say that together. Are you ready? Ephesians 3, verse 20. And it says, God can do anything far more than you could ever imagine or guess or request in your wildest dreams. I love the Message version of that because it just reminds us that God is a God of the impossible. There's nothing too hard for our God. Do you guys believe that? Awesome. Go ahead and repeat that. Remind yourself of that throughout the week. Make sure you know that God is the God of the impossible. He can do anything farther than your wildest dreams. Amen? Amen, amen, amen. All right, let's continue on because we have so much to do today. We're going to get right into our announcement time. Yes, it is announcement time, and we have so many exciting things happening here at KB Kids. First and foremost, guys, you have one more week to get your KB Kids challenge in. I'm hoping some of you guys are going to send me some rap videos of you singing along to the rap, or maybe you created your own dance video. Whatever it is, we are challenging you to come up with a video for the KB Kids Rap Challenge, okay? So make sure you send that to KBKids, WCCKBKids @gmail.com. All right, and don't forget, it is VBS, July 26th to the 30th. We are going to have VBS here at WCC, and I am so excited. Our theme for this year is treasure, knowing that you are priceless with God. Okay, we're going to check out a song from our VBS as we're learning them as we go. So when VBS comes around, we will be ready. So check it out.
Priceless treasure, God knows me, God hears me, God is my comfort. I am His and there's nothing better, forgiven and chosen forever. when I pray. He always makes a way. I am his and he is mine, and I am the prize he came to find. I am a priceless treasure. God knows me, God hears me, God is my comfort. I am his and there's nothing better. Forgiven and chosen forever. I am a treasure.
Guys, I hope you guys are excited. I'm excited. Teachers, we're getting ready. It's going to be a lot of fun. All right, so don't forget KB Kids Challenge and VBS coming up soon. All right, let's get right into our offering. And if your parents text to give, they can use the information below on the screen. Let's go ahead and say our confessions together. Say, Father, I thank you as we obey your word in giving and receiving. I thank you that all our needs are met and that we are blessed to be a blessing to your people. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. All right, well, guys, it is lesson time. We are going to get right into our lesson for today. Now, like I was saying before, our theme today is high noon. And that was a time where maybe the bad guys and the good guys, they would square off. And, you know, you've seen those movies where one guy's at the end of the road and the other guy's at the end of the road. And they're kind of all just standing there with all their gear, like waiting for somebody to move. Yeah, it was so dramatic. But, yeah, so we are also talking about the God of the impossible. Now, back then, have you guys ever written a letter and sent it to somebody or received a package in the mail? Where back in the Wild Wild West, they had what they called the Pony Express. Now, the Pony Express was like a series of people who were on their ponies, which is called ponies, or on their horses, and they would move the mail from town to town until it got into its final destination. So one guy would start at one town, and he would drive, and he would, you know, ride his horse as fast as he could to another town, and then hand off the mail to that guy. And that guy would ride his horse to another town and hand off the mail. And the mail, you know, could move along that way. So maybe you sent a letter to grandma or to your best friend, and maybe 10 days later, she would have received it. And you're like, wow, that's awesome. You know, this is so efficient and so fast. Well, nowadays, when we want to talk to grandma, what do, right? We pull out our phones, we email, we Skype, we, FaceTime, we do all these things. And we could talk to people instantly. Like if I want to talk, you know, to my mom, I just send her a text and say, hey, mom, what's going on? Or I can call her up on the phone. Now, if you would have told the people in the Wild Wild West that, hey, all you got to do is, you know, send a text and then they can get it automatically, they'd be like, oh, that's impossible. Or, you know, tell them that you can order something on Amazon and sometimes get it the same day. Never. So they would have thought that was impossible. But now with all the technology that we have, we don't think any of those things are impossible, right? Because we know that it is possible. We've seen it before. And that's what it is with God. As Christians, we have to know that we know that we know that there is nothing impossible for God. So today in our story, we're going to hear from Joshua and how Joshua knew that he knew that he knew that nothing was impossible God. So he prayed a prayer and he asked for God for something that seemed impossible. But Joshua, he saw the Red Sea open. He saw the walls of Jericho go down. He saw manna in the wilderness. He saw quail come to, you know, the wilderness. He saw what God can do. So he knew that there was nothing impossible for God. But before we get into that, let's check out our animated video and learn more about our story.
As the Israelites fought to take the land promised to them by God, The people who still lived there shook in fear, knowing they would soon be destroyed. One of the mighty cities in this new land was so afraid they tricked Israel into making a deal for peace. They would do anything to stay alive. It wasn't long before the king of Jerusalem heard about this tricky deal, and he wasn't happy. He wanted to destroy Gibeon and weaken Israel. So he joined forces with four other kings, and they gathered with all of their troops to attack Gibeon. When the Gibeonites found out about what the five Amorite kings were planning against them, they sent word to Joshua, "Do not leave your servants to fight alone. Come quickly and save us from the Amorite kings who have joined forces against us. Please help us." So Joshua marched up with his entire army, including all of his best fighting men. The Lord said to Joshua, "Do not be afraid of them. I've already given them into your hands so that not one of them will be able to stand against you." After an all-night march from Gilgal, Joshua and his troops quickly caught up with the Amorite kings and surprised them in an attack. Just as God promised, he was with the Israelites. As their enemies ran for their lives, Israel chased them with weapons, and God dropped huge hailstones on them. In fact, more of them died from hailstones than from the swords of the Israelites. Joshua and his men did not want to quit fighting until the Amorites were completely defeated, but they were running out of time. So Joshua went to the Lord before all of Israel and asked for a miracle. "Please," he pleaded with the Lord, "make the sun and the moon to stand still over Gibeon." And the Lord answered the prayer of Joshua. God caused the moon and the sun to stop moving. This was an amazing display of God's power over his creation. Surely, the Lord was with Joshua, and he fought for Israel.
Wow, can you believe it? What a wild, wild story that was. I mean, Joshua prayed that God would keep the sun in the sky so that they can defeat their enemies. And God listened to him. They're like, "Oh, we're going to come against the Gibeonites and the Israelites." You know, "Oh, you know what? We signed a treaty with you. We're going to help you." So when the Israelites came against the army, they were winning. But the sun was going down, and it's really hard to, you know, fight people in the dark. You can't see, right? I just played a softball game, and it was getting dark, and so we had to finish the game because we could no longer see. It's hard to do anything in the dark. And so, Joshua's like, "You know what? I want to defeat this enemy, but I can't because the sun's going down. It's getting dark." So he prayed to God, and he said, "God, can you make the sun and the moon stand still?" It's like, you know how the earth just, you know, rotates on its axis, and, you know, the sun goes around and the moon goes around, and, you know, it's morning and it's night, and that's just how it is. It's like God just hit the pause button. Yeah, God can hit the pause button on the earth, guys. That's pretty cool. God just hit the pause button, and he allowed the Israelites to finish the job. And you know what? The crazy thing about that story is, not only did he hit the pause button on the earth, he also started dropping hail and stones on these people. So God was fighting for them. He hit the pause button on the earth for them. I mean, this God is an amazing God. And when we trust him, and when we love him, and when we follow him, there is nothing that he cannot and will not do for you. You guys believe that? I hope so, because it is so, so true. Guys, let's check out what our puppet friends have to say to us today. They always bring a hilarious twist to our lessons, so let's hear from them. Puppet friends, take it away.
Hey, kids. Hope y'all don't mind if I join you down here. It's high noon in the Wild Testament today, and that means it's time for a showdown. There's a big one going on right now. The Israelites are squaring off against the Amorite gang, and frankly, it's not going very well for the Amorites.
Hey, partner.
Who are you? Say, aren't you one of them fellows from the Amorite gang?
Shh. They'll hear you.
How come you're not there out there fighting with your fellow outlaws?
You kidding? Them Israelites are whooping us.
I know.
All I gotta do is lay down until high noon is over, then I can snake my way out of town to safety.
I wouldn't count on that if I were you.
Why not?
Because high noon's gonna be a little long today.
What? How come?
Because God promised the Israelites that the sun wouldn't go down till they whooped every last one of you.
You mean high noon is going to stay high noon?
As long as it takes, buddy.
That's impossible.
Nothing is impossible with God.
And God is on their side, which means there's only one thing left to do.
Go back out there and take your whooping?
No way! I'm changing to the other side. Hey! I'm changing sides! I don't want to be an Amorite anymore!
Smart move by that feller. Remember, kids, it may seem impossible to you, but nothing is impossible for God. Happy trails!
I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder, KBKBKB say. I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder, KBKBKB say. I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. Here we go. We're reading God's word. We're doing what we heard. We're spreading God's love from John chapter 3. We're memorizing scripture. We don't hide it in our hearts. And when we're old, we will never depart. Why? I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KBKBKB set. I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KBKBKB set. I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. Watch us.
All right, hey KB kids, we are back and we are doing game time at home. I have my nephews here. Can you guys say hi? I have Aiden, I have Gabe, I have Ethan here, and they're gonna help me with my balloon face-off. All right, so just like I said, you are going to get a balloon and then you're going to race back to your chair and you're gonna try to pop it with your bum bum, okay? So try to see how many balloons you guys can pop with your bum bums. Are you guys ready? All right, when the music starts, we are gonna go ahead and go. Thumbs up?
Yeah.
All right, here we go. All right, are you guys ready?
Ready.
All right, wait for the music to start, and we're gonna go ahead and
go.
Pop them with the bum bums. Go, 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 get your balloon. Go get it, get it, get it, get it. Sit, sit, sit. Push, push, push. These people banded together, five armies to go to war.
who were the people that banded all the kings together that the five armies went to war? What were the name of those people? Yes, they were the Amorites. Yes, the Amorites, okay? So the Amorites, their five kings, they got together and they said, hey, we heard about these other people and we are gonna come for them. If we all work together, we will defeat them, right? Nah, they were wrong. All right, next question, question number two. These people needed help against the five armies. So the Amorites went to fight the, remember? Gibeonites, yes. The Amorites went to fight the Gibeonites. And remember, the Gibeonites were those sneaky people who tricked the Israelites before and said, oh, we live far away from you, when in reality, they lived really, really close. All right, here we go. Question number three. God froze the sun in place to help these people win the battle. I kind of just told you a few seconds ago. God froze the sun in place to help these people win the battle. What were those people called? Yeah, God's people, the Israelites. Joshua prayed to God. He was an Israelite, that the sun would stand still, the moon would stand still, and so they could defeat the enemy. Very good, the Israelites. All right, two more questions. Question number four. I hope you're doing well with name those ites. Here it is, question number four. More of these people died because of hail than the actual combat itself. So more of these people got stones dropped on them by God than people who actually caught up with them and fought them. What were those people called? Yep, we're back to the Amorites. Yes, we're back to the Amorites. Remember, the Amorites were the ones who banded together and said, we're gonna fight those Gibeonites. The Gibeonites asked for help from the Israelites, and now God is kind of dropping stones and hail on the Amorites after he froze the sun. Press pause on the earth, remember that. All right, here it is, question number five. For all the marbles, bragging rights in your home, at least for the week, here it is. God showed these people over and over that he could do the impossible. Who did he part the Red Sea for? Who were the 10 plagues for? Who did he bring manna in the wilderness for? Who did he give the 10 commandments to? What were those people's names? Yeah, the Israelites, God's chosen people. He let them know time and time again that he was the God of the impossible. And I'm so glad he did. Do you know why? Because now I know that through all those stories, through the things that we have read in God's word, I know that God is the God of the impossible. And anything that I need in my life, I know he is faithful to fulfill those things. Do you guys agree? I hope so. I hope you know how much he loves you. I hope you know how much he is an God of the impossible. Whatever you need, you can go to him and you can ask him and know that he will have your best interest at heart. Amen? Amen. Well, guys, I am so happy you joined me for part four of our Wild, Wild West adventure. I cannot wait until next week when we learn more about the God of faith, the God of the impossible, the God who will do anything for us because he loves us. All right, let's pray together and close out our session today. Pray with me. Father, I thank you so much for each and everyone who have joined me for worship today. I thank you that we opened your word and we learned that you are the God of the impossible. You can do great things, far more than our wildest dreams. I pray for safety for all my KB friends throughout this week until we are able to meet again. Continue to speak to us and teach us what you want us to learn so that we can become men and women of God, just as you've called us to be. We love you and we thank you for loving us. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. Well, y'all, I am so happy you worship with me today. I cannot wait until next week when we meet again for virtual worship. But until then, you know what I gotta say. Bye for now, y'all. Catch you later, friends.
Watch us see this who we strive to be. KB Kids affecting the world around us positively. We are growing day by day. We are watching what we say. We are Kingdom Builder Kids and we're here to pave the way. Hey, we are Kingdom Builders, building up the Kingdom of the Lord. I am a Kingdom Builder. KB say, I am a Kingdom Builder, building up the Kingdom of the Lord. I am a Kingdom Builder. KB say, I am a Kingdom Builder, building up the Kingdom of the Lord. I am a Kingdom Builder. One more time, we are. I am a Kingdom Builder, building up the Kingdom of the Lord. I am a Kingdom Builder. KB Kids.